Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Alright guys, the first step is gonna be to download the latest drivers for your GeForce graphics card. The first thing we do is to Google GeForce Experience and download the latest version of it. When it's downloaded, you need to install this one. When you have downloaded and you are finished, go into this and restart your computer so your drivers are updated. Alright, after you have downloaded your GeForce Experience, go into NVIDIA control panel and we can start the whole process. We're just gonna take it from top to bottom. And the first thing we have to go through is this called adjust image settings. So you have to take this one called use the advanced 3D image settings. And then you have to hit apply. When you have done that, we are going to take on the most important thing, which is the manage 3D settings. Make sure to follow this very closely because this is the most important thing in this whole video for your performance and your gameplay. So let's get into it. The first thing is image sharpening. This one you don't need to do a lot on. I have it on here. Sharpen should be on 0.50. This one should be on 0.17. And you need to click this one. Remember to click this one, GPU scaling. And after that, just press OK. When it comes to the ambient, put it on performance. When it comes to the anisotropic filtering, put it on application controlled. When it comes to the anti-aliasing FXAA, put it on off. When it comes to the anti-aliasing gamma correction, put it on. When it comes to the anti-aliasing mode, put it on application controlled. When it comes to the application transparency, put it on off. When it comes to the background application max frame, put it on off. When it comes to the CUDA GPUs, put it on all. When it comes to the DSR factors, put it on off. So at this point, when it comes to the low latency mode, which is one of the most important things when it comes to your performance, you can put it on ultra, you can put it on. I used to have it on in the beginning, but then I got a very high-end computer. Then I put it on ultra. So the thing you have to do is, depending on your system and your PC, you need to put it on which one you want. Try it first with ultra, but if your games start losing frames, then put it back on. When it comes to the max frame rate, put it on off. I have it on because I play on controller. If you are on mouse and keyboard and you want to play on the highest frame rates, I recommend that you put it on off and get the best. When it comes to multi-frame sample AAMFAA, put it on off. When it comes to the OpenGL rendering GPU, at this point you need to select your own GPU. I have the one called NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3070, so I have selected that one. When it comes to the power management for the best performance, put it on prefer maximum performance. When it comes to the preferred refresh rate, put it on the highest available. When it comes to the shader catch, put it on. When it comes to the texture filtering, anisotropic sample, put it on. When it comes to the texture filtering, negative LOD bias, put it on allow. When it comes to the texture filtering quality, put it on high performance. When it comes to the texture filtering trilinear optimization, put it on. When it comes to the shredded optimization, put it on auto. When it comes to the triple buffering, put it on off. When it comes to the vertical sync should be off because, as we already know, you get lower latency. When it comes to the virtual reality frames, you shouldn't change this one. Just keep it on whatever it's on. When it comes to the virtual reality, put it off and you should be hitting apply. All right, one of the last things are set up G-Sync. We go in here and you need to make sure you have it like this. The important thing is that it is not enabled because without G-Sync, you get a better performance and lower latency, as we already talked about. After you have done that, press apply and you are ready to go and restart your computer so your drivers are updated. So there you have it, guys. If you like this video, drop a like. If you like content like this, consider subscribing. And as always, I'll catch you guys in the next one.